Now remember, I'm not making these videos for you. These videos are for me. I watch them. But if you happen to come by and watch them, you know, all is well. But also at the same time, I am making them for you, because we're all one. We rub off on one another. These videos are just my personal diary, and you get a sneak peek into my personal diary. These videos are nothing to me but Captain's Log, man, when you watch Star Trek. You know, I used to trade financial currencies for 5 years. One of the things that I learned about trading financial currencies is that it helps if you keep a log of your trades so that you can see your mistakes and learn from them. Well, that's all a diary is. You can write down all your thoughts of the day, and you know, and you can go back later on during the month or whatever, or a couple years later, and start rereading some of your record, your life's record that you put. You can say, oh, wow, damn. See what I'm saying? It's just a public record. And you can either put your videos on public or private. You can make a private record or you can make a public record. So, I do both. I have private videos and I have public videos. Most of my videos are public, though. So on my videos, I practice. I am the Michael Jordan of YouTube. I practice so much that I am very highly skilled in wisdom, understanding, and knowledge. In fact, I am the prince that runs the whole planet. You might not know that, but I know it. And I'm not here to convince you that I know it. And I'm not here to convince you that I'm the prince. I'll just let the proof speak for itself. And every once in a while, I'll throw in some proofs of my own. And you might hear the old biblical sayings that say something like this: you are known by what others think of you. You are known by what others say of you. Well, let's use some common sense with that phrase. If the whole world is lying about you, then you are not really known. And your revelation will eventually be known, because all truth will eventually rehab all lies. When the righteous rise forth, the wicked get rehabbed. The wicked don't go into hiding. At first they might go into hiding, but in the long run, they're going to get rehabbed. And there ain't going to be no more wickedness on earth forever and ever. Amen. And I am the final straw in the puzzle that's going to bring this about. I am from the bloodline of King David, that Father Cause and Mother Nature christened to rule the planet. And I am from the bloodline of the Iroquois Indian, which is the private side of the Cherokee, who were never defeated by the colonists of America. The colonists went into peace treaty with the Iroquois. And that's what opponents do. When an opponent realizes it can't defeat another opponent, he goes into peace treaty with them. And you can study all your war histories and find out that this is the case. But through the generations, that peace treaty was broken by the United States, and the Iroquois eventually became citizens, and they were given birth certificates, so that now they can actually put in an authentic claim of lien on their share of the resources of Earth. And seeing how my bloodline of the Americas is mixed with the bloodline of King David, the ruling throne of the earth, I am the top dog running the planet, undercover, behind the scenes, soon to be revealed to all ears and eyes that don't know it yet. And the reason why the Iroquois Indian is so important, mixed with the bloodline of King David, is because the Iroquois Indian occupied the land of New York. And the United States drafted their constitution after the constitution that the Iroquois Indians wrote for themselves and lived after. And if you know anything about the state or the land of New York, it is the capital of the earth. There's an old saying that you hear, New York is the capital of the world. Why is that? It's because it was the only natives of the land that were never defeated. The Chinese were defeated. The Philippines were defeated. The Japanese were defeated. Europe was defeated. Australia was defeated. Canada was defeated. South America was defeated. Africa was defeated. All natives of the earth were defeated except the Iroquois Indian, the natives of America. They were never defeated. New York is the land of the only natives of the land, the most powerful natives of the earth. Iroquois were tricked. And they were only tricked by betrayal. They were betrayed. But it had to happen. Mother Nature caused it to happen. Because the Iroquois Indians, like I said, had to come under what's called Prison Planet Rehabilitation. And the Iroquois were no exception. And the Iroquois fought just as violently within their own nation against each other as any other natives of the land would do. Therefore, they lived under the rule of the jungle, which was kill or be killed. And Father Cause and Mother Nature says, "That's enough, boys. It's enough, boys and girls. You will come under the system called Prison Planet, even though you are the strongest natives on the earth." So the natives of the Iroquois Indian went under Prison Planet jurisdiction, under a birth certificate, under the legal codes of a public attorney, to teach them rules and regulations called statutes and codes of how to get along and how to maintain peacefulness and safety within themselves and between their fellow brothers and sisters. Until such a time as they learned universal law, which is the law of agreements, where then they have, once they're rehabbed and proved themselves to be peaceful and safe, with wisdom, understanding, and knowledge, they could learn how to write up affidavits to rebut the assumption of the public attorney, who is only there to ensure that people get rehabbed, so that they can come out, sign themselves out of Prison Planet, and go into the third phase of mankind through evolution called creating your own reality, which will get them their eternal life. There is no heaven, there is no hell. That's all just figures of speech in the Bible of public attorney or private attorney. Hell is under the jurisdiction of a public attorney, which is putting your trust in man. Heaven is under the jurisdiction of your own self, your own thoughts. Without the need of rules and regulations, because all peacefulness is written on the tablet of your heart, which is love. Love one another. Be nice to each other. Be considerate. Be patient. Set the captives free. Bring forth the healing knowledge. No more death. Think on these things.